All right, good afternoon. We're going to go ahead and get started with the Finding All Variants with ClinVar webinar. Thank you all for coming. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and tell your friends. Great. So the purpose of this webinar, obviously, is to show you guys how to find all variants with ClinVar. Now, the nice thing here in either the NCBI homepage or in ClinVar, you can search for either diseases or phenotypes, gene names, or HGVS entries. So we're going to start with searching by phenotype. And so here I've searched cardiomyopathy. This is just from the NCBI homepage. What I'll see is that I'll get lots and lots of different hits with lots of different things. For ClinVar, I have a ton of hits. There are obviously a ton of asserted phenotypic variants linked to cardiomyopathy. If I go into ClinVar and dig a little further, I will see that I can facet these 7,075 hits that I get over here on the left. Now, these are all related to cardiomyopathy because that's what I search for. The first thing I can search for is what the phenotypic assertion is. Do they say this is pathogenic? Do they say this is a risk factor? Do they say this is benign? For the purposes of this demonstration, we're going to select the pathogenic ones. So now we can see that our clinical significance, the asserted clinical significance, is all pathogenic. Now, what ClinVar does is aggregate these phenotypic assertions of particular variants. And we consider them to be more trustworthy when multiple independent submitters have made the same assertion. So here, we're going to click on the ones that have been made by multiple independent groups. So we'll do that. And then we might also be interested in what the molecular consequence of those variants are. So we can see that we have some that are frameshift, missense, nonsense. And for the purposes of this demonstration, we'll just select the missense ones. Now what we can see is that we have a whole bunch of different genes here that are represented by this. And we can also see that in our display, we get the HGVS notation. So just to show you, I could search by the HGVS notation, and I don't need the gene name, parentheses. I can use the standard HGVS notation. And if I did that, this would take me to a specific ClinVar page. And this is what a specific ClinVar page looks like. If we dig down, I just like to point out that it's also cross-referenced to dbSNP as well as the Thousand Genomes browser. And these two stars indicate that it's been submitted by multiple submitters, in this case, three. Once again, as I said, we can also search by gene. Additionally, if we click on one of these gene symbols, say lamin A, it will take us to the gene page for that particular gene. So this is the gene page for lamin A, and what I can see is a whole bunch of the isoforms down here in the sequence viewer. If I scroll down in this same page, what I can see is that underneath the isoforms, I get a whole bunch of ClinVar variants. And I also get other information down here, which is really, really cool and will be the subject of another webinar. Anyway, so I see the ClinVar variants, and say I'm interested in one of the last exons, I can use just the range tooltip to go ahead and zoom in on the last part of the gene. And then I can mouse over one of those ClinVar purple boxes in order to show the variants in that particular region of that particular exon. There's another way I can do this, and that is by going to NCBI Variation Viewer. The easiest way, in my opinion, to find NCBI Variation Viewer is simply to Google NCBI Variation Viewer. Anyway, in Variation Viewer, we can enter a location, a gene name, or a phenotype, and we can find particular genes. Say we search for lamin A, it will display the gene symbol for lamin A, and if we click on this blue arrow, it will display the gene for lamin A. We can configure the display to show all the isoforms, but we can also select one of the last exons in this gene, zoom in, and then we can see in this zoomed version the ClinVar variants here. By the way, if you're interested in variation viewer, here's a link to a full-length variation viewer webinar. I'll give you a couple of seconds to copy that down. Also, you can get there from the NCBI YouTube channel. If we scroll down in the same page in variation viewer, we see that we can filter these variants by a whole bunch of different things. So we can filter only the ones that are in ClinVar, the ones that are in dbSNP or dbVar, that is either under or over 50 nucleotides, the ones that are asserted as pathogenic or likely pathogenic by ClinVar submitters, as well as the variant type and the molecular consequence, as we discussed earlier. So when I go ahead and filter by these things, I can look at the pathogenic, the asserted to be pathogenic variants just in this particular exon. The nice thing, too, is I can see for each of these particular variants how many publications in PubMed support those particular assertions. Going back up to the top, I can see that we can see three pathogenic variants in this exon by looking at the purple color of those particular variants here. In fact, the different colors correspond to different phenotypic assertions. I can also upload my own data into Variation Viewer, and that's covered more specifically in that Variation Viewer webinar I mentioned. Finally, I wanted to talk about batch download for ClinVar. And really the easiest way, in my opinion, to do that is to go to the FTP site. So if you go to ClinVar, which can be found at this URL, or just by Googling ClinVar, then there is a link that says go to the FTP site. And on the FTP site, it's trivial to get VCFs, a VCF of all of the ClinVar assertions, or those assertions in XML, depending on what you prefer to parse. I would like to thank the people on this list, formatted as a PubMed query, for help putting together this presentation, and I'd be happy to take any questions from the audience if there are any. Also, I should mention that I am here with Melissa Landrum, the group lead for the ClinVar database, and she will also be able to answer questions, should there be any that I cannot easily answer. So there's a question that's actually a very good question. Is there a controlled vocabulary for conditions? If so, where or what is it? If not, how are conditions named search? I believe that Melissa will be able to answer this question more eloquently than I, so I am going to pass the microphone to her.
Thank you, Ben. So in ClinVar, submitters can provide their condition to us in several ways. They can use an OMIP number, an HPO ID, an ORPHANET ID, a concept ID from UMLS, so there are several options. If your condition name is not really represented in any of these databases, you can also provide it to us as your own term. Once we receive all this information to ClinVar, we use the MedGen database at NCBI. So MedGen is really an aggregator of condition information from many different sources, including the ones I mentioned, OMIM, HPO, ORPHANET, UMLS, and it also includes novel terms that come in directly to ClinVar, which then are available to be incorporated into UMLS as well. So when you are searching in ClinVar, you can search by any of those IDs, but you can also search on just the term that you're interested, like Ben's example of cardiomyopathy.
All right. Are there any other questions? The slides will be available on the NCBI FTP site, but there will be a convenient link on the NCBI webinars page. Again, this video should be available on YouTube in the next week or two. And if you liked the video and thought it was informative, please tell your friends. With that, unless there are any other questions, we are going to go ahead and sign off. We hope you enjoyed this week's NCBI Minute, and we should have either an NCBI Minute or a full-length webinar every week for the rest of the summer. Have an excellent day.